Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. And we should be ready to rock. Oh, we were ready to rock until the lights went out. Lights went out, ladies and gentlemen. Special Monday night, September 24th event. There the trophy set, ladies and gentlemen. You can't see him in the dark now. But 2007 and 2008, the Oswego Kartway was invaded upon by the Galletta's Karting Club, actually 2006 too, and they swept the top three trophies both those years. That was Labor Day weekend, 2007, and the week after Labor Day in 2008, rain delayed it. This is a special bonus point race. Everyone in attendance tonight gets the same amount of bonus points. A winner will be declared, but they will not earn any extra points because the full field was not in. A few people didn't show, and yours truly will be announcing instead of racing. And Melissa Stevens, who was thick in the points race with a few of the guys that are racing, cannot race. So that's the rundown. On the 10th anniversary of Chris and O's meeting online. Also an anniversary of many things, many races at Galletta's. We've had many two or three or four classics have been on this day. Years back, 2004, 2005, 2006, 2007, all were in this general area. Eric Wolver and his Woolworth number 78 for seven or eight different owners that car's had before Eric finally stepped up to the plate and put it on the track with a rebuild. Thaddeus Humphreys, number 81. Dave is right there in the points with Eric. Billy Truex as well. Brian Galletta, Matt Stevens today's in the six. And here they come, ladies and gentlemen. And Woolworth is a driver today. Woolworth is a rocket, ladies and gentlemen. First time rookie out there. Ron Anguson, if I'm pronouncing it right, I'm sorry if I didn't. Eric is gone. They were 1 and 2 most of the race last weekend. Eric is, guess a caution, come out. Sorry about the focus, ladies and gentlemen. We were trying to get it set. It's tricky in nighttime races. It's an older camera, 1998 camera, I believe. Someone is pulling it in, and it's someone at Brian Galletta. This is basically a shakedown race for Classic. And for the cameras, apparently, too.
Everyone thinks they're clever racers out here. But I'm not out there. I am just, how shall I say, I am the mastermind. That don't sound right. I'm getting a little pissed off that my mouth is having partial paralysis right now. But let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, one of these days, R will see the truth. Who the hell put all these stupid fucking beads on me so I can't even talk right? You think you're got it all figured out, Chris, you fiddle. You haven't figured out nothing. In one of my moments of partial paralysis, total morons put these fucking beads all over me. I'm getting pissed off, Chris. These beads are weighing me down. I'm a dainty mortal. Small, handsome, and tasty.
Ogie, that's a little more than a little gross, Uncle Ogie.
Yes, Chris. I do enjoy grossing people out, you especially. One of the brighter nephews of mine, maybe the brightest, but when you are compared to me, nobody is really bright. I'll give you an incomplete grade. Yes. Well, it looks like even with these ladies out here, they're too idiotic to even complete. How many laps has that question? Not very many. It has bored me because you guys can't finish a race, you can't start a race on time. You can't finish a race on time. You are lucky that I am a patient man. My idiot brother, Wesley, doesn't have my patience. That is perhaps one of the reasons why he is the lesser of us, I should say.
Ogie, you put people down an awful lot, don't you?
It's hard not to when you are as great as me, Chris. You'll understand him, Lee. When you grow up.
Ogie, now I'm not appreciating this talk at all. I'm interviewing you for the Klassic and you're putting me down.
All right, what's your question, Chris? If you want to be a professional interviewer or something like that. What is your question?
A few years ago, Ogie, you claimed to kill all the speed monkeys in the woods.
Yes, a colony of them.
There's people that have called BS on that.
Yeah. Do I care what anyone thinks? Look at me. I am short in stature and great in looks, brains, strength, common sense, for crying out loud, look at you idiots out here in the freezing cold, racing. Are you kidding me? This is disgusting. And do you call this racing? You're sitting there like a bunch of buffoons.
Ogie, I really don't appreciate mocking our friends that race with us, our friends and relatives.
Yeah, you're right. It is interesting to see buffoons out there losers under the crest.
Ogie, I don't find entertainment in watching my friends lose. We like to compete. We don't want to make them lose. Perhaps that's why I'm sitting out here, and Matt's just testing an underused car. We want all these guys racing right with us.
You say that, Chris, but everyone knows the truth. The truth is,
Ogie, that's enough. I'm wasting disk space on you and your mouth.
Where's this big perm Brian Galletta anyways? What is he doing?
Apparently his car broke. He's one of the reasons we're out here tonight, shaking down his brand new car. Number 13.
Yes, I see the name of Doggy Style 13. How defined, Mr. Brian Galletta. Not. Now my glasses fell off again. Yeah, look at that. My idiot brother knows how to wave a flag.
All right, Ogie. We resume with Eric Woolworth back in the lead. He was dominant in the early going. Dave, second place. Let's see if he can get a better start. But Eric, really, what the?
What is it, Christopher? Can't you watch this in peace?
Brian Galletta getting past first time rookie. Is pulling away from the rest of the pack.
Doesn't take away from the fact that it is funny, Chris.
Oh. All right, it was a little funny.
That's the spirit, boy.
Ogie, stop spitting on the floor. We have to clean that up, Ogie.
After you kiss my ass, Chris. I would like to sleep and watch wrestling while I'm sleeping. Look, my idiot brother has collected my idiot nephew, and they are going into the shop. Apparently, Brian is busted again. Pity.
And the race is resuming. Dave looking under Eric. And gets up. Well timed pass by Dave, but oh, look out, ladies and gentlemen. Holy smokemoly. And Eric is off the track. Yes, it's Eric Woolworth, your leader. Until that, he was battling with Dave. And he broke. And he pulls into the pit. Something went wrong with the Woolworth mobile.
Yes, the first-year driver is all back up here.
Well, they don't do it on purpose, though. Okay. And the race is resuming, Ogie. The DS Humphreys 81 in the lead. Followed by Matty Joey, Matt Stevens. It looks like Eric is out. And it also looks like Brian is out. So two of the drivers that we... Billy Truax is in the rear. Two of the drivers we've raced for, Ron Ingeson is out there, first time driver. Matt's gonna take Dave Tester. He's not racing for points, but that never let Matt, it never stopped Matt from trying to win a race. He's a greedy little bastard. Out there challenging Matt. Excellent job. This rookie has potential. We've heard he raced at Cartway before and was kicked out by probably, you know who. Uh-oh. Tires brushing. Going through. Back up the third. No Brian, no Eric. Those were the two leading guys charging for this race tonight.
Matt now testing, David. He's gonna test him in the long gear belly through act now. He's looking to trap Matt. He's picking up the tricks rather nicely already. And Matty! Matty goes back! And Dave gets cracked by Ron. Dave's probably gonna say, I regret bringing you. You cracked me out of the race. That always takes these cars that they're in the back of the pack all season or unraced all season. He hops in them and wins. He's just a crafty little man. Some drivers to do that, some are pulled into the backfire. I remember Jimmy Champagne used to do that. Doug Hebron had a car that wouldn't pull it. And Hebron's role model, Jimmy Champagne, hopped in the thing, hooked that thing up, and it was a burner after that. And Bentley Warren drove it. If we're not with the Oswego Speedway, we went there as kids and haven't been going as much lately, but went to track is spaced out now. Still on the track with Matt. Matt really has nothing to worry about here. We could just call it. We can wrap Matt up and put a little all on him. There, much like I wasn't going to be out there. This does not actually count as a feature win, or you could maybe count it as a heat. We could count it as a heat and then run another heat with the people that did not run in this race. This could be a jumbo heat for extra bonus points. We'll figure it out. It's right now it's just a bonus race for practice for running down the carts before Klassic, as that may be our next race outside shot racing next weekend, but likely this is it. Thanks, ladies and gentlemen.
Wait a minute, Chris. You didn't finish the interview with your Uncle Ogie.
Ogie? Interview all day. Fuck you.